Immunotherapy of cancer is a big term that includes all treatments that activate your immune system to fight cancer. My lab stands out because we're really interested in understanding the molecular responses on the immune side of the equation when we talk about cancer-immune interactions. We're working towards having more people benefit from this type of therapy because a big downside of immunotherapy still is that it's only a fraction of patients responding. And by understanding what happens when the immune system fails, we will hopefully be able to advance the efficacy of immunotherapy. So we're focusing on many cancer models right now, including lung, pancreatic, and melanoma. And this is because, for instance, melanoma responds really, really well to immunotherapy, while pancreatic cancer is very dire and doesn't respond to immunotherapy. And by focusing on multiple cancer subsets and multiple cancer types, we're trying to elucidate what are the overarching mechanisms that lead to immune resistance. So my lab's specifically interested in two types of immune cells, the first being CD8 positive T cells. And these T cells are specifically licensed to kill and eliminate cells that are malfunctioning. And the other subset of cells that we're interested in are cross-presenting dendritic cells. And these dendritic cells are critically important to activate CD8 T cells, specifically in an anti-tumor immune response. One very specific technique that we're developing in the lab is called intravital imaging, and that allows us to actually take a peek into the tumor and visualize the interaction between cancer cells and immune cells on a living mouse. One really exciting part about being at MIT is the interactions between biologists and engineers, as well as grad students. One specific project that is evolving in my lab was initiated by a grad student. The project is aiming to develop a deep learning algorithm which will help us to predict which molecules and pathways we have to perturb on the human side to actually enhance the anti-tumor immune response. By doing so, we're trying to elucidate overarching mechanisms as well as really deep down molecular mechanisms that we will then be able to translate into the human setting and hopefully have patients benefit directly from this.